And, you know, I think I missed the studio.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, I missed the, like, being in there, picking the beat, because at least that was what you was on, like,
yeah.
Like, what beats, at least, like, what beats should I do?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we would definitely, I was more a part of the creative process early.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, as you, I would say, like, around maybe Cuffin season one, when I kind of was like, he's just going to rock out. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And then now it's just like, I wonder what it would be like if I would just make an album with him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And yeah.
This is what it has become. And
mm-hmm.
it's been really, really fun for me. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? And also, like, refreshing in a way where it's like, dang, I bet you he thinks it's dope. Like, because he can just come in and cut three records mm-hmm. and not really have to write them.
Right.
And he really, like, believes that they're good
mm-hmm.
enough for him to just be like, all right, I'm just going to cut the records.
Yeah,
you know
sure.
what I mean?
I definitely think it was a good timing. You know, I know we always, like, we talk about it and joke about it. Like,
yeah.
Man, later on, you know what I mean? I'm going to do an album. You know, we will always say it. But
mm-hmm.
I feel like we just been in such go mode of, like I said, chasing. Like,
yeah.
Feeling like, okay, we need this. And then, you know, I think last year was when it was just like we really kind of hit a space where we realized, like, mm-hmm. okay.
No, definitely.
No, we
both
good.
Of us.
Yeah, so it was just like the perfect time. And then I think with you, I think just showing like any interest, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It was never like a, all right, peace out, you know what I mean?
Right,
like,
right.
I got it. It was definitely like a, yeah, I got it, but it was never like a, it was always like.
No, never was like a.
It was always like
here.
A, yeah,
nah,
yeah, yeah,
it was,
yeah, yeah.
It was definitely me, like, I mean, it was just, got. I just got so used to, like,
mm-hmm.
oh, you want in the booth? All right, I, you know
out.
What I mean?
Yeah,
like, I'm out. Like, I know what's about to happen. Like,
yeah.
I'm about to write this song,
mm-hmm.
and then we got the beats already picked, so
we gonna
the engineer just going to load up another one. I'm going to be here for, like.
Yeah, nah, it made, yeah, it made more sense, so, you know, for us to both be, I think, power here.
Right,
so
right.
So now with it back, I think even people seeing us a lot together more, you know
yeah,
what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah.
It been like nostalgic in a sense of them being like, man, I ain't seen y'all together in a minute. You
right,
know what
right,
I'm
nah, because I just noticed that just recently, you know what I mean? Like, it used to be like when either you would go by yourself or I would go by myself, like, we hated it because it was like the only question they was asking was,
right,
where's Eric? Where's Eric? Where's Eric? Where's
yeah,
Eric? Or,
yeah.
Where's Neiman?
Yeah,
where's
yeah,
Neiman?
Yeah.
Where's Neiman? And now it's like, it's not like that. Like, I just noticed, like the new people that are around,
mm-hmm.
they don't know that.
The story, yeah.
They don't
know any of
they
it.
They don't know nothing.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah.
they really don't know, like,
a
bro,
lot.
I used to be there every day.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You
and
know
I
what I mean?
I think for me, it's so embedded, like, even for someone to not know, I'd just be like, damn, you don't know that? You know what I mean?
Right,
it'd just
right,
be
right,
weird.
Right.
I'd just be thinking that people supposed to know it, but, you know, the same way we have to think about, like, man, if we don't ever tell them, how could they ever know?
Right, right, right. Now, that was, like, one of the reasons why I wanted to, like, just start talking on camera, just to, like, because it's a lot of things that people don't know about
mm-hmm.
us that
mm-hmm.
is, like, I kind of want them to know that.
Yeah.
You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
But, you know, you've been, like, a good sport throughout, because you've really been letting me have my way.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, not, because, you know, you're really particular
mm-hmm.
on, like, cover art,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? Track listing,
mm-hmm.
order of
mm-hmm.
songs, song title, you know, and you really been letting me just have my way. Like, you know what I mean? You ain't asked me if we could do the cover art
mm-hmm.
a certain way. I
oh,
just
yeah,
been
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Hey, this is the cover art.
You yeah, know? Yeah.
All right, cool.
Mm-hmm.
And, but, you know, I mean, for the people, they don't really know, like, it definitely is not like that.
Right.
When it's like a Eric Bellinger project, it's
right,
very
right.
much so like, all right,
It gotta coincide.
Yeah, like I mean, it gotta be fluid, like, and they gotta tell a story, and I mean,
everything, like everything.
The cover art, it gotta be purple because I said purple on. Like, I'm like, bruh, like, to the point where I be like, hey, bro, you just do the cover art, bro. You just let me know when.
Right. Nah, but it was dope because I think I have enough, you know, recollection and, like, times I could go back to, you know, when, like, okay, Neem would say, like, this his favorite song, or this his favorite song, or he liked this one, or we should go with this one. You know, like, it's been enough instances to where it panned out good, you know what I'm saying? to where it was like not a question, you know. I think we've been through our times to where, you know, now the same way with you, like, man, I miss the studio, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, like it's a creative process that, you know, just being away from it, now being back in it, I can see how dope it is that I was able to say, man, I miss this too, you know what I'm saying? Of, you know, me not feeling, because I think it started off for sure as like a, this is my story, I gotta tell my story, you know what I'm saying? And then I think after like maybe like a while, it is like, man, I'm doing this all alone. You know what I'm saying? Right. You start feeling like, damn, I'm like, this is a lot, like, musically. You know what I mean? And I think having the load off, like how you say, like, what? Chris Brown come through, like, yo, E, I need this. This is what I'm thinking. And you know, he go over there, and then he come back, and like, what you got? Boom. You know, that feeling is, I didn't know what that feeling was. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I always was on the giving end. So to be able to walk in and be like, yo, check out Say Less. I'm like, what's this?
right, so this for me?
So I'm just supposed to cut this one? Is this song open? You know what I mean? So to know like, yeah, no, this is like curated for you. It's like, you know, as an artist, especially somebody that has come up, you know, the way I did as a service, you know, and to, you know, be the person behind the scenes, to know that, you know, I was over here and somebody was working for me is definitely appreciated too.
Yeah, because to speak on that, I remember very vividly, like, the way we would pick the songs for the album, we would probably cut like 47 songs. And I would essentially pick the songs. Like, I would be like, all right, I like this song, this song, this song. And we would only have like a one song discrepancy where it would be like, I really didn't like a song. Mm-hmm. And you would be like, but I really want that one on it. And it was like, well, it was only one song. So, all right, cool. We'll put, you know what I mean? That was kind of how it went for like, maybe like Born to Sing Volume 3. The Rebirth was like, the reason why I was 32 because it was the older songs. So that didn't, you know what I mean? Well, so I just picked the newer songs. We put the older songs. And then that's why that one was 32.
Yeah.
But we normally recorded hella songs. Then that would be like the day. Like, right, where we'd be like, all right,
pick them out.
Here's all the songs.
Write them down.
And we'd be like, writing them down. All right, this is a mixtape song. I remember that vividly. So this is a mixtape song.
Buzz
this
record.
All that. Like, and we would have those. And then, you know, I mean, then we got into like, I got to tell my story mode.
Yeah.
And then it was like, all right. You know, and I think that's like kind of like the relationship that we have is like, it was like, for me, it was like, all right, cool. Like, do that. I'm not even going to almost try to interfere with that. You know what I mean? Like, do that joint.
You know what I mean?
And that's what it was.
It came out good because I think when you have curiosity as a person, as an artist, you know, you got to get certain things off your chest. You got to get certain things off. And as a creative, that's the main thing creativity is, you know what I mean? Getting off ideas in your head and like seeing what it would sound like, you know, going from your brain and transferring into MP3 form and then figuring out what it looked like, and then figuring out how to present it, and then, you know, seeing the reaction, you know, like, and then doing the shows, and then feeling the crowd. It's like, it's so many different steps to, you know, overall one project, you know what I mean? That is dope to, you know, just be able to do it with the same vision, you know what I mean? So, you know, to kind of just get back to how it was when we started is definitely refreshing, and I think the people gonna see it and receive it in a way like with of inspiration too, you know what I mean? And you know, sonically, I think they gonna get to hear me how they originally did, because I went through so many styles of how I recorded music. You know, like, I started off, I remember, I was listening to some older stuff the other day. Like, man, I had a lot of harmonies and I had a lot of intricate things that I was doing that I kind of strayed away from along the way purposely on certain albums. You know what I mean? Like, this one, we not going to do harmonies. This one, we not going to do ad-libs like that. This one, we going to be catchy only. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I think when I would experiment each album and each time in my life would cause something different. And for this one, since it was like it's already written, it allowed me to, I was like, well, I gotta still do something. So it made me make it sound like an Eric Bellinger song,
right?
You know what I mean? Okay, now hold on, let me pull out harmonies again. Let me pull out ad-libs again, because, you know, for the past couple albums, you know, I think I've just been on my bars and like I ain't really been thinking about harmonies like that. It's like, I'll throw you a little kiss here and there, but, you know, with these songs, I have more time to be creative with arrangement, like vocal arrangement, because I wasn't writing.
Was it like songs on there that you didn't really agree with the words that it was saying, the topics, but you just was like, I'm going to just record anyway?
I think so. But I still think I might have like flipped maybe like three or four words that would make it make sense to me. Yeah. You know what I mean? So, and I think that just comes from me knowing who I am and knowing what my supporters like to hear from me and don't like to hear from me over time. I just got to see like, all right, cool. Y'all really want the real me. You know what I mean? Y'all can tell if it's something that's not quite me, you know what I mean? And they gonna question it in the comments, and they gonna ask like, well, what happened to this part? Like, man, y'all really listening? And I think that's a good thing, you know, because it means my branding has been thorough, you know, and they've been able to pick up on the, you know, character and the ammo that I've been giving them, and you know, to be able to, like I said, have the songs, and they should be able to maybe just a little bit of, you know, like fine tune or personalization. You know, that's
yeah, because I mean, I definitely got to kick me out of, you know, being in the studio with the writers and, you know, almost kind of telling them like, yo, when you write this song, kind of look at what I'm doing. Like, look at the way I'm dressed and, like, talk about this. And it was kind of like, I knew that it wasn't, like, all the way what you would write. But it was like, because it's me, I know he's going to record it. So I got a kick out of it. Like, when you was recording them, I'm like, look at him in there. Like, nah, he not even saying nothing. Like, about it. He's just going to record it. Like, because there was some of them that I didn't use that was like, dang, he really recorded that. Like, I think there was like one that you had recorded before I made the decision. I'm not going to use that one. And then I, but I was thinking in my head, like laughing in my head, like, oh, he still recorded that. And there was one where like, you didn't record yet, but you were ready to record.
Right, I think I had the session loaded.
Yeah, ain't good enough. Yeah. Like, you were gonna record it, and I couldn't wait to be at that session, because there was definitely lines in there that I was like, Like there was like a eating butt line in there. Uh-huh. And I was like, I wonder if he's gonna say that shit. And I was wondering what the flip was gonna be. And mm-hmm. I was like, but I just didn't think it fit for the project at the time.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, this has been like a fun experience, and I think that, you know, like with even just like the marketing of it, it's kind of like I wanted to kind of like take the stress off of you as well, like to where I kind of came up with a marketing plan that was like, you just really have to just post the songs, mm-hmm. not really like be involved in like, you know, going to the dance class and mm-hmm. like doing the challenge and posting all the people on, you know what I mean? Like I kind of like created the marketing plan in a way where it was just like, you know, almost like how mm-hmm. an artist is at the label, like to where they kind of like, they don't really be knowing what the marketing plan is. Right. They just kind of like do the turn of album in and then mm-hmm. y'all niggas just, you know, they mm-hmm, do their thing, mm-hmm, or somebody mm-hmm. might post for them. You know what I mean?
No, yeah, it's definitely a rollout and just situation. Even when I've been doing interviews, it's just like, yeah, man, like, need to put together a whole, you know what I mean? I'd be juiced to just kind of explain it just so they can know, you know what I mean? Yeah, like, yo, he, you know, came with the songs, he came with the art, like, everything, to the point where I got to just come to the studio and, like, and kind of see what it would be like to me when you're doing it with a major. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? Because I look at it like I've been seeing artists that are on a major label in the way that they work and operate. And a lot of stuff be just handed to them. You know what I mean? That's why I think like when they like finally get out their deal, they don't know what to do. Because mm-hmm. they're just so used to, you know, the label kind of making all the decisions for them. But this, for me, I've kind of seen it the opposite way. Mm-hmm. I'm used to doing it by myself.
Yeah.
So now it's just like, oh, you got, oh, I'm chilling.
You know what I'm saying? Even in the budgeting, it's like a lot of all the albums we have to come together and be like, all right, we gotta mm-hmm. pay
mm-hmm.
this producer, this cover art, da 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 da. You ain't seen no invoices for this. Like, right, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, it's been that too, like, where it's like,
yeah.
And, you know what I mean? Paying for everything. But this is becoming really fun for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, it really is becoming, like, I don't see it like a job.
Yeah,
like
that's why
cover arts or mm-hmm. like whatever. Yeah, talking to the producers mm-hmm. or the writers or whatever. It's actually like fun putting the puzzle together. Like,
yeah,
you know sure. what I mean? Like, because you know it's all a puzzle. Like you know you start off with a beat, and then you like have to figure out what writer can go writes well with this type of beat.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And it's like, you in the studio not really knowing what they gonna come up with or if they gonna kill it or not or
right,
what.
Right,
you know what
right,
I mean?
Right.
So you like really in there like really like putting the puzzle together, like mm-hmm. I think this cover art should look like this, and you know what I mean? Like it should have these colors, and
mm-hmm.
it's really like a fun process.
Dope. Yeah, it's tight, man. I think it's the best thing. This music job, you know.
No, it is. You know, I hear this guy, he's like a motivational speaker guy. His name is Grant Cardone. And he kind of speaks to entertainers and athletes like, oh, you guys have to work so hard. And I'm like, if you, when you read, like, the 4-hour work week, this book right here, when you read Timothy Ferris' The 4-Hour Work Week, like the ideal situation is an internet business that is like low management. Like the management only has to deal with like $100 problem. They mm-hmm. can deal with it on their own and they don't need me.
Mm-hmm.
With music, it's even easier than that. There is no customer service. Once we put the records out, that's it. Mm-hmm. There's no refunds. There's no manager, like there's no customer service reps needed. Mm-hmm. It's like, and the song is getting played throughout the night. at all hours mm-hmm. of the night. Like, music in the way that we're doing it is probably at the top of ideal.
Yeah.
Like
it, no, you see it, you know. You see it on Instagram. You see it, you know what I mean? Everywhere it's like, man, you know, these rappers, mainly rappers. You know what I'm saying? Especially, I think when you see it with them, it's like, do they really have all that money? Or do they really have all them cars or diamonds or houses? And, you know, I think with, like, people that do it independently and just on their own, like, for example, like a Tech N9ne or something, you know, like, mm-hmm. people only see right now. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I think it's because, like us, we built our following. You know what I mean? Once you get the cult following and have people that believe in you, if you're not tapped into that world, you have no clue.
Right, right, right. You know? But I also think it what with ours, the reason why it's so disguised is because of the way that we structure our finances. Like, mm-hmm. we don't buy anything unless we can... Like, if the note, like, if our car note is $2,300, then our philosophy is like, you better have $30,000 in the bank. You mm-hmm. better have a year worth of payments
for just to
buy that. Mm-hmm. So when we buy something, like if we buy a $40,000 watch, we probably got $400,000 in the bank.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, we just do shit differently. Yeah. So it doesn't look like we have millions of dollars, but the way that we structure it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, and I think that's where
mm-hmm.
you know, some days I do feel guilty in a sense to where, like, I literally some days and more lately will watch a whole series in one day. Mm-hmm. Like a whole, like, 10 episodes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, bang it out in one day and be like, And be feeling guilty, but then be like, well, what else you gonna do?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know it's coming in. Like,
yeah,
it's coming regardless.
Yeah, that's the joy of just putting our foot down early. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and just being like, we just gonna do this.
We're just gonna do this. And, man, I'm glad we just kind of stuck to it. You know, it was a lot of times. You know, for me, that people was just like, you should just keep writing. And it's like, what if we just had to keep writing? Like,
that's
crazy.
I don't even want to talk about it. Because
it's like, bro. I mean,
dog, like, I couldn't even imagine if we kept writing. Like, we would be poor.
Right.
It's just simple as that. Like,
mm-hmm.
you know, I won't name many names, but, like, there's people that did keep writing.
Mm-hmm.
But they ain't got no Ferraris,
right?
No Rolls mm-hmm. Royces, and mm-mm. they not even close.
Mm-mm. And it's funny because at first it was so frowned upon that, you know what I mean? Like, oh, you shouldn't do that. And I think because we did it so early, we jumped, you know, out, and you know, we were able to build it. And I think now people trying to do it is just so mm-hmm. late.
Man, it's just so late. Tough. Like, when I'm talking to people, like, I think that we were so much of, like, people's champions and, like, just people's people
mm-hmm.
that, like, it's kind of hard to do that now. That, like, it's hard to relate.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because it's like, dang, like, I don't know what it's like no more to be, like, wanting to go to all the events or not being able to, like, afford certain shit. You know what I mean? Like,
especially when you need something.
Yeah,
we need, like, that. I can't get it.
It's like, what? Right. I don't even know what that, like, not like that, but it be certain shit. Like, I be talking to people that's like, you know, there's a lot of people are, like, they be wanting advice.
Mm-hmm.
And it just be like, whoa. It's such an interesting thing, but also, like, people aren't willing to work as, like, that. I don't think they would have wanted to do what we did. Like,
mm-mm.
you know, I moved away from my family for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they lived somewhere else, and I moved to North Hollywood to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it wasn't like.
Right, and you're not talking your mom and dad.
Yeah, like, I'm talking about, like, my wife and kids. Like, mm-hmm. I moved away from them for 2 years to do this music thing. And mm-hmm. everything that we had, we put into music. Like, yeah. There was nothing else.